black people with afros, and they're coming out the sky, and they're going to beam us up. And while we're getting beamed up, we're going to look down, and we're going to see that destruction, and it's going to look like a lake of fire.
There you go.
We're like, go ahead.
First Thessalonians 4 and 5th, I'm sort of 15. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout.
Shall descend from heaven with a shout. Oh, I got that shout. Hold on, go read that.
Shout.
I got it. Hold on.
For the Lord himself shall descend from earth, from heaven, with a shout, with the voice of the archangels.
All right. Now listen, I got to back up on that shout. Listen to this. Revelation 18:1. And after these things, I saw another angel. That just mentioned angels too. Another angel come down from heaven having great power, and the earth was lightened with his glory, and cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the Great is fallen, is fallen. Because America is known as Babylon the Great in the Bible.
It's out of here.
Okay.
It's out of here.
It's going to be destroyed.
Proud devils.
The Babylon the Great is fallen, is fallen. It's become the habitation of devils and the hold of every foul spirit, the cage of every unclean and hateful bird. I'm just going to skip down. I'll just read it off. For all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication. Because America's committed fornication with all nations, has she not? Even America's symbol is a woman, the Statue of Liberty, a transvestite, a woman. It's the spirit of a woman in America. That's why it's called the Whore of Babylon.
Yeah. You see what happens when a woman leaves. You see the bomber bitch that was running the CIA when doing her goddamn job. The motherfucker had a criminal on the elevator with the president. So there was a breach in security because of this woman running shit, you know. She resigned. It was in her ass. I can imagine the feeling. I can imagine how they was in her ass, man. She resigned.
Well, they had a bitch, that civilian's bitch, was charging the IRS. Mm-hmm. She got caught up in a scandal. What are y'all?
All these women.
You can't
look
have
a... Look at the Columbus School Board.
Harris. Gene Harris. That was, wicked asshole.
All that wicked shit that was going on with that bitch, man. That bald-head, ugly, nasty bitch.
I hate that bitch.
I hate that bitch, too.
I hope that bitch catches AIDS and drops dead.
Mm-hmm. Catches AIDS and a bullet.
Yeah, and a bullet.
Then burn the fire.
That'd be beautiful.
Man, that was my principal in school.
Really?
Oh, that's fucking in high school.
That bitch is evil.
Yeah, she was evil back then. I hated that bitch then. She favored the students that was well taken care of. They had money. You know what I'm saying?
Always.
Niggas, that was middle class. Back then, it was Uncle Tom ass, you know, middle class niggas. You know? I grew up with nothing but Uncle Tom ass middle class niggas. Even to this day, they acting like a bunch of fucking
niggas. You see a lot of that out in Whitehall. Mm-hmm. Let me read this. And I heard another voice from heaven. Now this is going to back up what he said. Read that again real quick.
Okay. For this we... Oh, okay, 16. 1 Thessalonians 4, 16. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout.
With a shout.
With the voice of the archangel.
With the voice of our... Now listen to this. And I heard another voice from heaven saying... This is that shout. He's saying, because when he's saying this, he's going to be a shout. Saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. So that's the Lord, because a lot of people use this scripture to say, to come out of Babylon spiritually. This means to literally come out of Babylon and get beamed up into a UFO. That's what that's talking about. So go read all that again, and go all the way through. Come out of her, my people, means the Lord coming out of the sky in his chariots, saying, come on up. And we get beamed on up. That's what it means.
For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel.
I was just thinking of Price is Right from Bob Barker. Come on down. You know, because only a few people get told to come down.
For doing the whole show, it's like, what, 3 or 4 people?
Yeah, okay. I went to the Price is Right.
Did you really?
Yeah, I was like, I ain't get to go down. But so, Lord willing, I get beamed up in that chariot. You know what I mean?
Right.
Go ahead.
And with the trump of the Most High Yahweh.
You go that trump.
And the dead in the anointed shall rise first. Then we, which are alive and remain, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds.
In the clouds, it's talking about the chariots in the sky. We're going to go up into the clouds. And this ain't talking about when you die and go to the pearly gates. No. This is talking about while you're alive on this earth, in this world, the Lord's going to come out the sky from outer space or wherever he's at. He's coming out with the angels. And the scriptures say, every eye shall see him. Okay? Every eye is going to see the Lord and all those legions of chariots in the sky. They out there right now chilling. If you come out here on a clear sky, on a clear night, you see chariots flying around everywhere.
That's what we get. These people are catching more and more chariots. They're getting closer and closer. There's some badass videos out there.
Yeah, I follow some people on Twitter that post UFO videos. And there's so many UFO videos, you get tired of watching them. Don't you? I mean,
it's a lot of them.
There's so many of them, it's not even a big deal no more.
That's right.
You know what I mean? But it is a big deal, actually. It's a very big deal.
Yeah.
Well, to us, you know, to these fools, they still don't believe it.
That's going to be terror to them.
Or if they do believe in UFOs, they think the Anunnaki's coming. You know, or reptilians are coming. Or the Greys.
Then we, which are alive and remain, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord.
So we shall ever be with the Lord. That's talking about the kingdom. Because the kingdom is forever. See, this world, Satan's kingdom, only lasts a few thousand years. So that goes back to the point of long suffering. Well, they got beamed up.
Right.
It's like Enoch got beamed up. Oh yeah, in the book of Enoch, don't be talking that shit on our channel either.
Okay.
Yeah, and everybody wanna talk about the book of Enoch. They don't know anything about the Bible. They can never tell you anything Isaiah said, but they know that Enoch won't it.
Okay, here you go. This is 2 Kings 2 and 6. And Elijah said unto him, tarry, I pray thee. Here the Lord has sent me to Jordan. And he said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. And they too went on. And 50 men of the sons of the prophets went, and stood to view afar off. And they too stood by Jordan. And Elijah took his mantle, and wrapped it together, and smote the waters. And they were divided hither and thither. He's just like they did the same act as Moses.
And Joshua divided the waters too. Remember when they went so they could go through the water, the river?
Okay. So that they too went over on dry ground. And it came to pass when they were gone over.
Man. That's why it's called Babylon. I like to go hide out in the woods up in the top of a mountain somewhere. Get away from this shit.
It's like a shot in your body when you're somewhere and it's quiet. You like, no. Like, whoa.
Go ahead.
And it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee. And Elisha said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me.
Oh yeah, he said, I want to have that strong spirit like you.
He had a good role model.
Well, yeah, right. It's pretty much he was his mentor, his father in the truth, you know? So you rub up, yeah, if you're somebody's teacher, you take part of their spirit with them. You ever notice how you hang around with a person a lot, you start acting like them? You know what I mean?
Say certain things.
Yeah.
It's like being around a wicked motherfucker.
Oh, yeah, if you hang around with wicked people all day, you're going to be acting wicked. That's like your boy Dave.
Yeah.
I told Dave, too, man. I told you. Don't hang around two-thirds. You will get the punishment.
Esau hates instruction. Israel takes it beyond.
I got to reuse that story to Exodus. I wonder if they'll show that in the new Exodus movie, the Israelites begging to go back to Egypt.
You know what I mean? Hey, what the fuck we look like giving this dumbass bad advice for? How that's benefiting us? How's that been? How are we being holy men, righteous men?
Yeah, cause
giving him bad advice.
Yeah, because brothers will think you're being too strict or too harsh when you tell them not to hang around two-thirds. You're like, look, they're no good motherfuckers. Don't hang around with them. You done told him the truth once. It's okay to give somebody the truth. Hang out, even they smoking and drinking and acting like demons and partying and all that. You can go hang out with them, give them the truth. The Lord did that. He was hanging with the sinners and prostitutes. You can do that. But once you give them the truth and they reject it, which maybe after they reject it twice, actually. And when you know they no good, you stay the fuck away from them, okay? You don't keep on back. Like we said, that's like playing with a snake. That's like me trying to charm a snake.
He had his doors open to him, man.
You cannot charm a snake. It's going to bite your ass.
He had his door, well, you know, what his crib, but he was staying with that.
Yeah.
This got like 20 kids, about 20 different niggas. He had, every time I went over there, man, the house had, I mean, talking about the type of niggas you just, I mean, you hate to look at somebody and judge them, right?
Yeah, I mean.
But sometimes you look at a motherfucker, you like, no.
You can just tell by their spirit. Like, I got to get away from these motherfuckers.
Tell by Dave's spirit. He was the one that went out with the gun and did this shit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, he did shit worse than they did, probably.
Yeah, right.
Or robbing people.
He was probably the architect.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah, he was probably the architect behind it all. You know, because them ghetto niggas are stupid. Never been out the hood. Never been nowhere but on their block.
Yep.
Boy, you know?
I'm talking about like your boy Kevin, too.
Yeah. Stupid.
He done heard the truth a million times. He came out here.
He was coming out for a while.
He came out, yeah, they was high on pills and shit coming out.
No, I seen him like 2 weeks ago and he wants to come back out.
Oh, is he in his right state of mind?
Yeah, he's got a wife and a kid now.
I mean, you never know. Like I said, the door is always open.
You never know.
Yeah, the scriptures say you're supposed to forgive your brother 7 times.
It is a Jacob.
Right. You're supposed to forgive your brother. Okay, because some people they got a hard time getting out.
He was kind of cool.
Yeah, he was cool. I mean, Kevin's cool.
Yeah, he was cool for
him. He's cool. You know, actually, the first time we ever went out teaching, Kevin was the cameraman downtown.
My very first
video ever, he did the camera.
Yeah, he was kind of cool.
Yeah, he's cool.
I never had a problem with Kevin, man.
But they want to, you know.
I never knew that about them coming out all high though.
Oh.
I never knew that, man. Until a little while later.
They told me.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Most high got rid of him.
He told me he came out high on ecstasy.
Wow.
You ain't supposed to teach the Bible high on ecstasy. So you wonder why he was so in the spirit.
That's why Dave is watching TV through bars.
Gotta share the toilet with someone.
But yeah, I mean, we try harder not to judge people, but look. I know it's hard to get off them drugs, right? But you gotta let that shit go. Let it go.
All that selfish nigga shit, let it go.
He's just pleasing the flesh.
Shit, Dave ain't even been to court yet. He's still at the workhouse.
Damn. Sleeping with the lights on for a month straight. God damn.
Oh, it's been longer than a month.
Fuck.
I thought he was like crazy, man.
Yeah, you will go crazy in the workhouse.
Because your body feels like you're getting different to you.
You're not even guaranteed a bed in the workhouse. Some people gotta sleep on the floor.
Oh, what happened to the speedy, fair trial? That proves the court system's all fucked up. You know what I mean?
They're trying before 90 days, though. It's gonna be 90 days. They probably gonna wait till that 90th day and then they're shipping right off. Let me finish this.
Man, you better pray to the Lord to let his ass out
I doubt that happened.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
He's getting 5 to 10 years.
See, you know what? Honestly, I, he deserves this too. He does, man. Because he did. There was a time he stopped going out, then we had mercy on the fucking fool.
Let him back.
And then immediately he just stopped again. So, you know, them strikes is a, hey, when the Most High's whooping your ass, you feel me?
Well, he's about to let him back again before that happens.
Yeah. Sure was, you know. Because we're merciful. You know what I'm saying? Because he's a brother, like the scripture said. Brother keep going off and he repents. Forgiving. I'm always willing to forgive a brother, man.
I'm not really one to hold grudges, no way.
Right.
I'm really quick to forgive. Probably too quick.
It's a blessing to have brothers, man.
Yeah.
It's a blessing. You know?
And people like to think that we're assholes and we're super strict and really, you know.
Do we seem like wicked niggas to you? You know what I mean? For real, man. It's a blessing. And it's on you if you reject it or not.
Like we said with the two guys we know. Them two guys. Like I said, there's always the door is open. You know what I mean?
Always.
Well, not always.
Cool motherfuckers.
Yeah, they cool as hell.
Cool motherfuckers, man.
Yeah, but like I said, you know.
You better hurry up before the Most High really puts this wrath. His wrath.
Because I know, Guy, you still junior. I know you still in Columbus, ain't he?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know where we at.
So he's good with him. That's right. Okay, here we go. And it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee. And Elisha said, I pray thee. That, this is crazy. Scriptures is bad, man.
Yeah.
Now, we're talking about getting beamed up, but the spirit took us somewhere else.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just a lesson. It's just a lesson. You know?
But it's like a stream, a creek, a brook. You know what I'm saying?
This way, that way.
You know what I'm saying? Like Bruce Lee said,
the roots.
You must be like water. Water can flow or water can quash.
Right, right. That's bad, man. I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. And he said, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see me when I am taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee. But if not, it shall not be so. And it came to pass, as they still went on and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot of fire.
A chariot of fire coming out the sky. It's a UFO. Well, it's a IFO. It's identified.
They had turned into, in the movie, a fucking horse pulling a chariot on fire, like the Ghost Rider.
Oh, yeah.
They had turned into some shit like that.
But a lot of movies will show you, though, and they'll disguise as aliens, like Close Encounters of the Third Kind. Mm-hmm. If Steven Spielberg, that damn devil, he knows about the Bible.
That's a bad movie, man.
Because that whole movie is about a chariot to the Lord.
Yeah, that's a badass movie.
Yeah.
There's some fire close when, what was his name? Richard Dreyfuss?
Yeah, Richard Dreyfuss.
When he put his head out the window,
yeah,
and his son burned half his face.
I gotta say, you know, I haven't watched that movie in over 10 years.
Within the last 4 or 5 months, I probably watched it like 20 times.
I need to watch it again, bro.
That's my shit.
I ain't seen it. That's, you know, I seen movie. That VCR tape at the thrift store today. I should have got it.
That's a bad movie.
Oh, shout out to the thrift store, and that's all of a sudden, I found a big old stack of Godzilla tapes.
Oh, wow.
Bro, I got like 6 Godzilla tapes for $1.60.
Damn. I still use my VCR.
Hell yeah, every day.
Yep. And it came to pass that they still went on and talked that, behold, there appeared a chariot of fire.
Chariot of fire, coming out the sky. Keep going.
And horses of fire.
Horses of fire.
And parted them both asunder. And Elijah.
Boy, the Lord might come out the sky. The Lord could do whatever the hell he wants. Reading that book of Maccabees, had the angel riding on the horse. Pretty much like a Pegasus. What do you think a Pegasus is?
Let's see if I can find that one. That's bad too.
Yeah, that's bad.
Because he described how the angels actually like running. It was like they was running military drills.
Yeah.
It's crazy, man. It's crazy. And horses of fire imparted them both asunder, and Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven.
I bet the horses of fire. Who knows what that's talking? It might be talking about the fire around it. I don't know.
Horses of fire, just horse power, just like saying power.
It'd be good to read that scripture in Hebrew too. Mm-hmm.
Seeing the majesty of that size of that giant thing is just powerful, man.
Yep.
You know?
Like Ezekiel said, he seen the circle, within the circle.
He saw some bugged out shit.
Yeah, he just sees some bugged out shit.
Yeah, yeah. Most high just don't send some simple shit to you. He sends some bugged out shit.
Even the book of Revelation talking about them strange creatures chilling with the Most High on his throne, the beast.
And Elisha saw it, and he cried, my father, the chariot of Israel.
The chariot of Israel. That's like the old Negro spiritual. Sweet chariot, swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. That's talking about the so-called UFOs, the chariots of the Most High. And they're going to take us home.
That's right. The chariots of Israel and the horsemen thereof.
We're going to be like Captain Kirk out this motherfucker. Yeah, even Star Trek's based on the Bible, okay? What's his name, Gene Roddenberry? He studied the Bible. That's where he got most of that shit. Is he a Jew? Probably so.
I don't know, they're
robbed. I've never really looked. He made some weird shit, didn't he? I like some Star Trek.
He has been, right,
that shit. Yeah, I can't lie. I like me some Star Trek.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite shit of all time.
I can't lie.
Star Trek.
And people talk shit about William Shatner. Yo, I thought he was a marvelous actor. But just in the Star Trek movie. I don't like seeing him in nothing but Star Trek.
That was a perfect role for somebody to play.
Yeah, well, he played. That's all he could do was Captain Kirk. That's it.
Captain Kirk.
He can't do nothing else.